that works fine. If I cut here, protect it. If I cut here, protect it. So the problem is, if I go straight for you, because generally people do will do rapier like this. If I go straight for you, you've got to make a decision. So if you come straight into the frame, which one do I do it with? This? I could do it with this. Or and it's got a line in the Yeah, but by the time I've figured out which one I want to use, it's too late and the point's here. So, don't do that. Don't make yourself think in combat. So, either how we teach it, we teach a couple of things at Vanguard. So, the basic philosophy is whatever's out in front, that's your defensive weapon. That's what your opponent's got to get past. This is the attacking weapon. Whatever's back is the attacking weapon. So I'm not going to hold it like this, so I've got to make a choice about which I use to attack coming straight in. I'll do it like this. This is the defensive weapon. You've got to get past this somehow. As soon as you do, I got this as a backup. This is also the attacking weapon. So if you thrust in at me, I can parry, try and block that with your dagger.
Yeah,
if we do that, then a whole bunch of other stuff's going on.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. I'm
going to try to keep the knee to a minimum from now on.
Yeah.
Good advice.
Or if I hold them on this side, same thing, even better. If you thrust in, parry, I can step out and around. I've got that. Yeah, long legs. Bad things are happening for you. We even call this, when we see people do this, that's a triangle of death. That's, that one. Oh, I've been stabbed. But sometimes it appears like that, the triangle's up on top. Well, that's it. You can do cross parry, it's a different thing. It's a different thing. I'll parry with that one and do something. Yeah, and you still got to think. You don't want to think, you just want to react. So, one of the other ones, dagger forward. Yeah, this is the defense. You've got to get past this, and then I've got this thing here.
So you could just shoot down like that.
Yeah, but don't hold it. A lot of people will just hold it in the middle. I've still got to make a choice there. Is the attack coming above or below? That's below. Oh, that's above. I do that. Yeah. If I hold it like this, I'm not really worried about anything coming above. Any serious attack is going to come below. So as soon as I see you move, I've got it, and bang. Or hold it the other way. This is the defense, this is the attack. I'm not going to worry about anything coming to my legs. Well, it could, but you open yourself up and you're so, anything coming in at my body, as soon as I see you move, I've got it. So think about that. Which is the weapon that's the defense? Which is the weapon that's the attack? cool.
Damn, there goes those dollar signs.
And that's the if you're going into a comp, especially against Capoferro people, I do that. Do the Joseph Sweatman one. The dagger out in front, whether it's high or low, don't care. You don't have to think. You know where the threat's coming from.
You're going to enter the Capoferro tournament, aren't you, Josh?
Pre-prepared defenses, pre-prepared action.
That's what you're saying.
Right. Yeah.
So that's where I'm up to with what you're saying earlier.
Yeah.
So, okay. All right. Yeah.
The last one. The one with sort of my sort of French reading background that I do is, this does everything like it would if you didn't have anything in your hand. What this is for controlling the blade. So if I keep them together, actually in the same sort of line. So if I'm holding it in fourth, that's on my hip, this is a little bit above my hip. So I've got them both on the same side. If I'm holding it in third, that's basically on the hip. This is pretty much in that same vertical plane. Because what I'm doing here is, when you thrust in, this is doing all the work. This is the attack and the defense. But as soon as I've parried, and if I have to step back and do it, whatever, don't care. As soon as this is parried, I use this to control your weapon. I can move it out, I can move it wherever, but more importantly, I have a tactile sense. I have a tactile, you know, kinesthetic body sense of where your weapon is. So I don't have to think about whether I'm safe. I know I am. And I've opened up a hole in there. Or on the other side, I can do it here. Yeah, I've parried. I've parried safely. Can I attack safely? Am I safe to attack? Don't. No, no. Keep it there the way it was. Bring that across. Now I know where your weapon is. I'm safe to do something. I can feel it. I can feel it in me. That is... Because I've tried all this stuff. I've just been